What's going on, y'all? Here I'm playing Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Blazing. I'm doing the Orochimaru Impact mission. The character that I'm choose for this mission is 3 Sasuke Curse Mark II, 1 Rock Lee Strike Mission, 1 One Tail Naruto, and 1 Sakura Wizard 4 Star that you can get from the storyline. I want to break down this team, why I use this team for this mission. Sasuke is really, really good to go against with a boss fight. The perfect dodge may you not take any damage. That's always great. And at the same time, you are recovering your chakra. So then your hard hit unit can do their ultimate to the boss enemy. So that's always a plus. Rock Lee is there is because Rock Lee carried me through the mission until to the boss fight. He is a body type unit and a AoE jutsu attack, so he's always great to have for this mission. One Tail Naruto is there is because he's my hard hit unit. I don't have any body type unit that can do hard hit damage, so then I'm use him. But I am highly recommend y'all to use a character that can do slit damage is because it's better than a One Tail Naruto. But if you don't have a character that can do a slit damage or any strong body type unit, then you can use any other hard head unit beside skill type for this mission. And the last character for this team is Sakura Wizard, the 4 star that you can get from the storyline. Why I choose her in this tank is because I don't have a healer. If I do have a healer, I will replace her, but I don't. So I keep her in this tank because of her fail skill that she have. If she's close to an ally, she can recover 150. That's really, really great. She also have a perfect dodge jutsu. So that's always great when you need to recover your health. She can do her jutsu and then get close to an ally and they recover 150, or if you have 2 ally close by her, she can heal like 300 each turn. That's always a plus when you need to recover your health. This is why I bring this team for this mission, as I break down what the strategy is. That's why I've used this team for this mission. I also want to point out that before enter the boss fight, make sure all your character have max chakra and you have a full health bar. So then when you enter the boss fight, you can use the hard hitter jutsu, ultimate jutsu, to do the most damage at the beginning of turn, and then you can recover their chakra and then do their ultimate again for the maximum damage that you can do. Now we in the boss fight, you want to start out with your hard hitter unit first, so then you can do their ultimate jutsu or your character slit damage first, so then they can do their slit damage, and then you switch to Sasuke or some other unit that can be using potassium like how I just did with Sasuke. So that's the strategy, just using Sasuke. If you have Sasuke, just use Sasuke perfect dodge until your hard hit unit we cover all their chakra maximum, and then they can use their ultimate jutsu again. And that's the strategy I use for this mission. I hope that this strategy helped y'all to think that what character to use for this mission. And I will let the video play. this how you beat this mission. Thanks for watching my video and catch y'all later.